I don't know if this is gonna make a difference, but gotta move, man. Gotta get those activity rings closed. Come on. YouTube, it's your boy, BMAC'S. So you guys know I'm an Apple Watch geek. You guys know I'm also an Apple Watch apps geek. But did you guys know I'm also an Apple Watch face geek? It's true. I basically am an expert on Apple Watch faces. So in this video, we're gonna talk about three of my personal favorite Apple Watch face setups. And with dozens, if not dozens, hundreds, actually probably not even hundreds, probably thousands of different combinations you could have with the watch faces on your Apple Watch. With all those different combinations, you guys have been asking me lately which Apple watch face I use and what complications I use on that watch face. So without further ado, let's just get right to it. I'm gonna take off my Apple Watch, put it down in front of us right here. I'm gonna show you which watch faces I'm using and what complications are going along with those faces. First up, we're gonna talk about a watch face that is available on all Apple Watch models. This is the color watch face. As you can see, the color watch face allows you to customize both the color and look of the analog watch face with this particular watch face itself. And you could do that by force touching on the Apple Watch display, clicking customize, and then you will immediately see that the first edit menu, the first edit tab you have here, allows you to change the color. Personally, I like to match the color setting within a watch face to whatever band I'm wearing at the time. In this particular case, we have a desert brown color band. So I'm gonna change the watch face color to match that just by scrolling through using the digital crown until we find one that's pretty similar to what we're using. I actually like this color right here, light pink, so we're gonna keep that for now. By the way, more information on the bands and accessories I personally use and can recommend for the Apple Watch can be found in the video description box below. So check that out in case you're interested. But once you have your color selected within the color watch face, you're gonna wanna swipe right to get to the second tab within the edit menu. And here is where you have three different options to choose from. You have dial, circular, or full screen. Now you can't add any complications to your Apple Watch with this particular full screen setting. So I'm never using full screen. I'm either using circular or my personal favorite, dial. But if we swipe right one more time, this is where the magic really starts to happen. Now, as is the case with most Apple watch faces, you could completely customize which complications are actually on the watch face itself. You see, I have mine set up here. In the top left, we have the moon phase. Currently, there is no moon there because it's a new moon. In the top right-hand complication, we have the date. On the bottom left, we have the carrot weather complication, which we'll talk more about in just a second. And then in the bottom right, we have the messages shortcut. But what I think makes the color watch face so special and why it's still one of my favorite watch faces of all time is this option right here in the middle to turn on a monogram. I think that BMAC monogram is super cool. You can customize yours to say whatever you want. I think it's an awesome way to personalize your Apple Watch that much more, make it that much more your own. In case you're wondering how to set that up, I actually have a full video tutorial for that. A card annotation is gonna pop up on the top right-hand corner of your screen. You can click that. Or as always, you can click a link to that video tutorial in the video description box below. That's pretty much the Apple Watch color watch face in a nutshell. But next up, let's talk about the watch faces I'm now using on a daily basis. The watch faces I'm about to tell you about are a little bit more advanced, actually a lot more advanced than just the color watch face. And basically, on the day-to-day, the two watch faces I'm about to show you are my go-to. I'm usually swapping between one or the other. And the two I'm talking about are, with the introduction of the new Apple Watch Series 4, we get the Infograph watch face and the Infograph Modular watch face. One of the first things I noticed with the Infograph and Infograph Modular watch face is the amount of information that is actually displayed on the watch face itself. Believe it or not, throughout the day, I'm usually not actually using my Apple Watch in the sense that I'm not actually on it, opening up an app or something like that. The majority of the day, I'm just looking at my wrist, glancing down at it, and getting the information I need on the watch face. Let's take a closer look to show you exactly what I'm talking about. First up, let's talk about the Infograph watch face. Now, this is my second favorite Apple watch face of all time because of how colorful and futuristic it looks, while still maintaining a minimalistic, clean, and organized look. This particular Apple watch face allows for 8 different complications. 8 of them. That is twice as many as we just had on the color watch face. And you even have the ability to add more information, like the text we have in the dial up here as part of that top sub-dial complication. In this case, it says the forecast. This is just an incredible amount of information readily available for you with just a quick glance down at your wrist. And for me, personally, I find that super helpful and super powerful. You can customize this Apple watch face by force touching on the watch face itself and then once again clicking customize. You'll see a familiar color edit menu here like we had on the color watch face. And once again, you could use the digital crown to select whatever color you want, and in this case, I'm once again going to match it to the band that I'm wearing. Once you've selected your color, you could swipe right once again, and this is where it gets kinda nuts. Now this might look like it's a lot to take in at first, but I promise you, it's a lot simpler than it looks. You have your four complications in the four corners of the watch face, then you have four what I think are called sub-dial complications within the middle, one of which actually has the option to add that text to the top part of the dial like we mentioned before. For this particular setup, I have the sunrise and sunset in the top left complication. I have the carrot weather high and low forecasted temperature of the day with the current temperature. I have the messages shortcut in the bottom left, and then another monogram style complication in the bottom right. This could be achieved with the application called Complicate. Complicated allows you to actually select your own monogram on particular watch faces where the monogram isn't available. You can find more information on the Complicate application in the video description box below this video. And then we have our three subdial complications in the middle. On the left subdial complication, we have our activity rings, which are disgustingly below what they should be by this time of day. On the right subdial complication, we have the date with the day of the week. On the bottom, we have the current wind speed and wind direction. And then on top, we once again have another carrot weather complication, this one that tells me the forecast and the current weather conditions. I highly recommend you check out the carrot weather app. It is easily my favorite weather app for the iPhone and for the Apple Watch. More information on carrot and a download link can be found in the video description box below. One of the things I love about the Infograph watch face is the cool gradient you get on certain complications like we have here with the forecast at high and low temperature of the day. You can easily see the low and the high and where on that spectrum we currently are with the current temperature through that awesome looking gradient. I can't get over how cool that looks. Something new and exclusive to the Infograph watch face we get on the Apple Watch Series 4. And that pretty much does it for my Infograph watch face. That's my setup right there. Like I said, that's a lot of information jam-packed onto such a small screen, but believe it or not, the Infograph watch face does a really good job of organizing all that, and it presents all that data in a very clean, non-messy way that's easy to read and understand. So it's pretty obvious how much I absolutely love the Infograph watch face, but lately, I've actually been using the Infograph modular watch face and enjoying that one just a little bit more. I've been super into minimalism for a while, as you can tell from like this minimalistic filming setup, and all my setups are usually minimalistic. Everything I do is minimalistic. So what better way to extend that minimalism than on my actual Apple Watch with the Infograph modular watch face? One of the first things you'll see on the Infograph modular watch face is how much easier it is to see the time of day, the day of week, and the date. Don't get me wrong, I love analog style watch faces. I'm a classic kind of guy when it comes to watches like that, but sometimes you just need that time read ASAP with actual numbers so you don't have to look at the analog watch face and spend the extra couple seconds figuring out what time it actually is. With the Infograph modular watch face, the time could not be simpler and easier to see and understand. Now, you don't have color customization options within the Infograph modular watch face, but you do get the complication customization options, and that's what really makes this particular watch face stand out. Technically, you get five different complications, one of which has to be modular style like we have there in the middle. But starting things out in the top left, that's where I have my activity rings. On the bottom left, we once again have the moon phase. In the middle, we have that beautiful gradient, once again with the high and low temperature of the day and the current temperature supplied by carrot weather. We have our messages shortcut in the bottom right. And then this is what I love most about this watch face, the carrot weather supplied forecast hour by hour. I have a full outlook on the day's weather in such a confined, easy to understand and read space right here, right on the watch face. The current temperature, the current weather conditions, when sunrise or sunset is, and the weather conditions and temperatures expected hour by hour over the next 10 hours. That's incredible. Back in the day, you'd have to wait like 10 to 20 minutes watching TV just to get a forecast like that. And rather than opening up an app or Googling what the weather is, you get the full daily outlook instantaneously just by glancing at your wrist with this particular complication right there. I think it's pretty easy to see why this is my personal favorite Apple Watch watch face right now, and why I think it's the watch face you're gonna fall in love with too. The amount of information you get in such a well thought out and organized manner is revolutionary. The Infograph and Infograph modular watch faces easily bring a whole new experience to the Apple Watch. It's what I consider a feature of the Apple Watch Series 4, a feature I specifically call out in my Apple Watch Series 4 review video. And in that review video, I said that the Infograph and Infograph modular watch faces, for me personally, were reason enough to upgrade, and to this day, I think that still holds pretty true. The Infograph and Infograph modular watch faces, even though those are considered software features, to this day, those are still two of my favorite features on the Apple Watch Series 4, mostly because of how much use I actually get out of them. If I could glance down at my wrist and get all this data I just talked about instantaneously, to me, that saves on time, that helps me be more productive, and overall, it's pretty amazing when you think about it. So color watch face, Infograph watch face, and Infograph modular watch face. Those are my three main watch faces that I'm rocking on my Apple Watch. At any given time, in any given video, most likely you're gonna see me rocking one of those three Apple watch face setups. It's my go-to daily setup right here on my wrist, and I highly recommend you choose one of the three to rock for yourself. But I'm curious to hear about your Apple watch face setups. Which watch face are you using, and which complications are your favorite? Please do not forget to annihilate that like button and subscribe with notifications turned on so you never miss a new video on this channel. And as I said before, I am disgustingly behind on these activity rings. I don't even think working out tonight is gonna be enough to close these rings. I think I'm in trouble. Better start running or something. I don't know what I'm gonna do. I will see you guys in my next video.
I don't know if this is gonna make a difference, but gotta move, man. Gotta get those activity rings closed. Come on.
They didn't even budge.